Hey everybody, this is Praxis, and Josh and I are back on site today, and Josh has been doing a lot of sanding in here. I've asked him to take a few minutes off just because the sand is really loud, but he's been doing sanding. I've been working on these windowsill and window header kind of boards, and the reason I'm putting these together now is because I can't really do much else until we get the slab in. I've been kind of poking around the things that I can do, but until we get the slab, we can't support the floors. Until we can't get the floor supported, we can't really make everything nice and level. So, I'm trying to work on other things that I need to do anyway. The value of these little sills, aside from being kind of cosmetic, I think they kind of dress it up a little nicer than just having a couple 2x4s on end, but they serve a structural benefit. As you can see above me and below me, there are no floorboards. Now, I'm walking on these boards here, but these are temporary. This whole area is just open, as is above. You're going to be able to stand all the way on the bottom floor and look all the way up to the ceiling up there. It'll be a huge, open, cool space. You can grow a tree in here, pretty much. One thing that you lose in doing that is that the floorboards, they provide some structural stability to these floor to the floor joists. They kind of hold them together, keep them from splaying out. And the floor joists are what are holding these columns together. So without the floor joists having the stability of the floorboards holding them together, they're not providing as much structural grip onto all these posts over here. Now, the architect designed this and he said that it's fine. There's other things that are holding this wall together, but I always like to over-engineer things. If you can put extra strength in something, why not do that? And that's one thing that these sills and the headers are going to do. They're going to bind all these posts together and kind of hold them together like that. Now, this one went in pretty easily, but the next one I have to notch because it has to go around these floor joists. And I wanted to show you the tools that I'm using to do that. And one of them is in my hand right now. It's a chisel. Now, a chisel and a hammer, that's kind of a primitive tool. It's been around for millennia. But they're super useful for certain types of tasks. Now, I need to get a little notch pulled out of here. Now, I used a little handsaw to make the two ends, but the width of it, it's too narrow to drop like a powered handsaw in there or anything. So I'm just chiseling it out, and it's pretty simple to do. You just pop the chisel in and just start pulling out pieces. I usually like to start by putting kind of a line, like scribe a line where I want to have my nice clean finish line. I do that beforehand. But after that, it's just popping pieces out one at a time until you get down to your line. So even though it's a really simple tool and it doesn't use power and it's not very expensive, it's a super useful tool for some types of jobs that otherwise would be really difficult if you had to try to, do this just with power tools. So that's it. Josh and I are going to continue to work today. We are waiting for windows to show up. We have three windows. You can see plastic, still haven't been delivered. They're supposed to be delivering them this morning, but in about 23 minutes, it's going to officially become afternoon. But, that's the story of this project, things not being delivered when they're supposed to be. But we'll see. That's it. Thanks for watching.